Hey guys, this is Mark. In my previous video, I talked about core database concepts, and they are tables, columns, and records. And in this one, we are talking about data types. Data types directly relate to columns and records. Data types are extremely important whenever you start building logic for your application, and whether it's the logic for the front end, for the user interfaces, or for the back end, it doesn't matter, it is equally important. There are a lot of different data types supported by Backendless, but let's start with some basic ones. So for instance, if we think about text, text is going to be anything that you can put into quotes, and that becomes a data type that is called string. Every data type has its own operations that it supports whenever you start working with that data. So for instance, with strings, you can concatenate two strings together, and that becomes one longer string that contains two concatenated elements. Within a string, you can do searches for substrings, like if you have some text and you want to find if that text contains a specific word or a sentence or whatever, then the string data type supports that operation. If we're talking about numbers, then numbers support all the mathematical operations. So as a result, identifying the data types for the data that you're working with is going to be very, very important, and that is done fairly early on in the design stage of your application. So to give you a better idea of the data types, we're going to take a look at an entity. And what is an entity? Entity is just something that exists in your application. In my previous video, I was talking about orders and products. Well, those are entities. An order is an entity, and it consists of data that, and every data element has its own data type. So we will take a look at an entity that is called person, because it's very easy to understand. We all are humans. We understand what kind of properties a person has. So let's take a look at a person entity and identify properties that person entity has and the corresponding data types that would be used to represent those properties. So here we have our entity person, and every single person, and that's the thing, it's very important to identify properties that would be generic. Because by doing so, you can uniquely define that specific entity as it relates to your application. Some properties may not relate to your application. Here, this is just a general example. So if we think about a person, then we know that every person has a name, and that would be a property. Now, what is the data type for name? Well, that would be text or string, that's what it is. It is really a text. Then every single person has age. And age, the data type for age would be a number. And in the Backendless database, that data type is going to be integer. There are different numeric data types, by the way, and we will be looking into each and every one of them individually in other videos. But here, it's just an overview of person. Then every single person has gender, and gender could be a data type that is expressed as a string. There is a special data type in Backendless that is called multiple choice, where you can select one of the predefined options, and gender would be a very good candidate for that. Then there is eye color, and eye color is another good example of multiple choice, but still the data type here could be either string or a data type that we support is also color. Next one is hair color, very similar to eye color. Then we have languages, like the languages that a person speaks, and that could also be multiple choice, where you allow multiple selections, but still it is going to be a string. Then we have height, and that is a numeric value. It could be expressed in the metric system or with feet and inches, but still it is a numeric type. But you could still represent it as a string. So here you would need to see, you know, what would work better for your application. Finally, weight. It is also a numeric number. So these are kind of the properties that exist in a person. Why we're doing this? Because whenever you are designing your database table, table consists of columns. The columns in that table, they will match pretty much one-to-one to the properties of an entity that you are considering. And I will walk you through of creating the table for the entity called person. So let's switch to Backendless Console and define such a table for these properties that I have listed. So we're back in Backendless Console, and let's start creating table called person. For this, you will click this plus. And by the way, I am on the data screen in the BDB section. This is Backendless Database. When you click on plus in here, you can type in the name of the table you will be creating. Click create. The pop-up says that would you like to start creating the schema? And as you know already, schema is the combination of the definitions of all the columns and their corresponding data types. Click yes. And in here, let's start defining our very first column. It is going to be name. And then this is the type, all the data types that we have. In here, you select the one that fits the best. And this is going to be string. Let's click create another because we'll be going over all the properties that I defined. Click create. The next one will be age. Age is a numeric type, so we'll select int because it isn't going to be an integer, so we can express age with that data type. Click create. Next one, how about weight? Weight could also be numeric data type. Click create. Now let's define eye color. By the way, when we define the names of the properties, they need to be all one word without any spaces. This is just a requirement of Backendless. So data type here could be that multiple choice that I was talking about. So here's multiple choice. And in the multiple choice, you can select whether you want multiple selection or not. For eye color, it is going to be a single selection. And we can start defining values. So for instance, green. And here we have yellow, although yellow is kind of a really not exactly the color of eyes that, although you can think about yellow eye color. Next one, how about we say brown? And you can select a brown color. It is going to be somewhere here. These are the colors really just for visualization in Backendless. And how about we have black? And then we can select black color. So this way we defined values for the eye color data type. They will still be stored as strings. So this is sort of a simplification to provide that type of configuration. Click and let's stop right here. So we defined these data types. And as you can see in the data type column, it shows the data type that you have defined for our person entity. Now, if we go to data browser, now we can actually start creating a person, and we will be doing it by hand, but you could also do the same thing with API. All the API lectures are going to be coming a little later in this course. So click new, and let's say age is going to be 35, eye color, we can select brown, name, we can assign the name of that person, and then for weight, we can say it is, how about 120? Let's say if it is pounds. Now notice that in console, it forces you to stick within the data types that you have identified. So for instance, in weight, if I were to start typing letters, which are not numbers, okay, it doesn't let me save this because it says it must be of int type. So it's only numbers are accepted here. Okay, so now we have created the table, defined the data types for individual columns, and created a record. And now this record can be accessed through the APIs in your Backendless application. There are a lot of data types supported in Backendless, and as I said, we will be going over each and every one of them with a separate video. But here's a list of the data types that Backendless supports. As you can see, there are quite a few of them, and every single one has its own meaning and supports special types of operations that can be performed on the data of these types. This may sound overwhelming already, but don't worry. It will all start making sense. And for the majority of the applications, the data types that you will be working with are going to be strings, integers, booleans, date, time, values. By the way, I should have thought about the birthday. Well, by the way, let's actually go back and define date of birth, data type, which will be date time, as you can see right here. Back in Backendless Console, let's go to schema, and let's add date of birth. And the data type for that, it will be date time. Click create, and now if we go, we can modify the record for Joe, and then for date of birth, here it is. Let's say he was born sometime in 1996. We can select a certain month. Let's just pick one. Click done. So now this value, it looks like, could really look like a string, but it's not. It is a special data type that is date time. And date time has its own set of operations that you can perform in your application. Like if you have some date and time, you can calculate whether it's before or after and just retrieve records that fall within certain range of dates as an example of using that data type in your application. So that's my intro into data types. There will be a few other lectures before we actually get to review the data types, but this one is extremely important piece of knowledge that you need to have when you are defining your database. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy coding.